Adam, Idris, Nuh, Hud, Saleh, Ibrahim, Lut, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Yusuf, Ayyub, Shu'ib, Musa, Harun, Dhul Kifli, Dawud, Sulayman, Ilyas, Al-Yasa'a, Yunus, Zakariya, Yahya, Isa, Wal-Akhir, Al-Khatim, Al-Anbiya, Muhammad, Al-Mustafa.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praises due to Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon His beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, viewers all over the world, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, blessings and mercy be upon you, your families, your household, your friends, everybody who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're still with the story of Musa alayhi salam, with Bani Israel, the children of Israel. The story of patience, the story of perseverance, the story of tests, the story of fortitude, the story of Allah's victory, the story of going against all odds for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A story that all of us learn from, whether you are a son or daughter, whether you are husband or wife, whether you are rich or poor, sick or healthy, whether you are a person of authority or a person who is weak, whether you are a person who is oppressed, whether you are a person who is imprisoned or a person who is persecuted or a person who is powerful and strong, you have a lesson to learn from the stories of Musa alayhi salam, of Yusuf alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ayyub alayhi salam, Sulaiman and Dawood, and the best of them all, Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla and I invoke Him by His names and attributes. With His names and attributes, I invoke Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to, to forgive our sins, to fix our deeds, to define our goal and unite our efforts, to make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to. Allahumma ameen. Last time we talked about the story of Musa alayhi salam until he had to leave Egypt and he fled to the city of Madian, the land of Madian. And Musa alayhi salam, when he was leaving out of fear, he was afraid. But he made a dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla, Ya Allah, save me from the transgressors. Ya Allah, save me from al-zalimeen. Ya Allah, save me from al-zalimeen. Rabbi najjini min al-qawm al-zalimeen. Ya Allah, save me from the people who are transgressors. And Allah Azza wa Jalla responded to his dua. So after going in the desert, walking and being tired, thirsty and hungry, he reaches the water of Madian. Every city or every town, every locality were known by a well of water, water supply. So this is the water of Badr, this is the water of Madian, this is the water of this, this is the water of that. So until he reached the water of Madian and he find a scene, strange scene. وَجَدَ عَلَيْهِ أُمَّةً مِنَ النَّاسِ يَسْقُونَ. People, shepherds and others, they are getting their supply of water and they are crowded on that well of water. But he found two girls, two young ladies, تَذُودَان, they are taking a side, taking a corner. They do not want to join that crowd. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, he saw that scene and he saw how the other males, they are not helping or accommodating those two females. Instead, they are ignoring them altogether. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, out of his courage, out of his bravery, out of his chivalry, he stands up and he offers to help them and he goes, subhanallah, and he gives them the water that they needed. They have their sheep and the animals with them, so he gives water that they needed to them. Then he went straight to the shade of a tree. And he said, Ya Allah, I am needy, Ya Allah, to your khair, please send me some of your rizq provision. He's hungry, he's tired, he's exhausted. Subhanallah, after finishing the dua, he find one of those ladies coming back to him. And she's telling him, my father is inviting you to reward you for what you did with us, for your help. So he goes to the father. And he talks to him and he mentioned his story, told him, don't worry, Allah saved you from the transgressors of Egypt. And then he tells him, listen, Musa, I need somebody to help me and support me with work. How about if I give you an offer? Why the father said that? Because one of the daughters, she was listening to the conversation after Musa alayhi salam shared with him. She said, oh, my dad, hire him to work for us because he's strong and he is honest. And we'll come back to that in a minute. He's strong and he's honest. So he gives him the offer. He tells him, you know, I want you to work for me, and in return, I'm going to get you married to one of my daughters. And her mahr, her dowry, is that you work for me 8 years. And if you, out of your generosity, want to continue the 10, it's up to you, and I will not make it hard for you. It's your choice. أيام الأجلين قضيتوا, he told him, okay, I'm having a choice. It's not 8, I'm not forced to have 10. 8 if I want, 10 if I want. He said, yes. Of course, Musa alayhi salam, as we know later, he finished all 10. That shows us he always takes the most. Ihsan, muhsin. Remember, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal will never waste the reward of those who commit ihsan, who do ihsan. Those who do ihsan and commit to the act of ihsan, Allah will never waste their reward. And Musa alayhi salam was muhsin, and Allah rewarded him abundantly, subhanallah. My brothers and sisters, see, Musa alayhi salam, after the palace, after being, after living in this luxurious life, he finds himself in the street homeless. Always remember Allah Azza wa Jal. When you enter your big house or drive your fancy car, when you dress your nice clothes, brand new clothes, or brand new shoes or brand new watch, remember that all of this are gifts from Allah Azza wa Jal that he can take at any time and he can take it back. He will not ask you about it. Appreciate and be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It can happen overnight. After you are loved and admired by people and everything you have, coveted by people and they want to have it, then suddenly it is gone. What remains your belief and conviction in Allah Azza wa Jal and his cause, which Musa alayhi salam had. Also, we learn from that, even though he's tired, even though he's exhausted, but it does not mean that he will take the initiative to help someone who needed help. And that was the characteristic of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Khadija told him, how Allah Azza wa Jal will abandon you and you are helping the needy and serving the poor and, you know, being generous with the guest. Those are the characteristics of prophets of Allah. So this is a lesson for us. Do not have an excuse and say, I'm tired, I'm exhausted, I'm not going to help that person. Actually, it's a golden chance, never waste it. Maybe Allah Azza wa Jal will give barakah in your health and your wealth because you're helping someone even though you're busy and exhausted. And also telling us how to deal with our women. And also telling us how women deal with the community. They did not go in the crowd and said, I'm a female, I'm a feminist, I have to go and crowd with men and I have to push them around and I have to prove my own self. No. They were shy and modest. The defining characteristic of a woman is being shy and modest. That does not mean weak. It does not mean submissive in a negative way. No, you're submissive to Allah Azza wa Jal. You are shy and modest. Haya. You're looking down and having haya and being fragile. But it does not mean be abused by men. It does not mean exploit that. Should respect. That's what Musa alayhi salam could not take it, sitting there while these women are there and these men being so negative and being so disrespectful and not accommodating the women. He goes and he's the man like them and stronger than them, and he gets helps and serves the women. A successful community is the one that their women are served, are honored, are respected. It is not the community that women has to fight for their rights. That's not a respected community. When the women had to fight for their right, that means the people are bad. The community is not good. The community is good as a sign that the women are respected and honored. They don't have to fight for, they don't even have to ask for their rights. They are given the rights and more with ihsan. That is the leadership, if you want leadership as a man. To serve the women and honor them. Then when Allah Azza wa Jal tells the wife to obey her husband, she knows now what does it mean. Because he is honoring her, respecting her, and carrying her over his head. with honor and respect, then of course she obeys him. Of course he takes the leadership of the household, but not the other way around. So Musa alayhi salam gave that without seeking any reward, without taking her phone number. I know this is funny, but I have to relate it to what we have. You don't do a favor to a sister just because you need a favor or you need to know her or social media or think something like that. No. You're doing it for Allah's sake, then you'll do it right. You'll do it for the right reason, the right way. And that's what Musa alayhi salam did. فَسَقَى لَهُمَا ثُمَّ تَوَلَّى إِلَى الظِّلِ. Give them what they need. You need anything else? No. Goes back to the shade. And then he makes dua to Allah. Allah, I did this for your cause, so help me. And the response comes at once. That tells us also that Allah's response will come to you even if it is delayed. The response will come to you even if it is delayed. Subhanallah. And then he goes to their father. He goes to their father. And the father tells him, now don't worry. Allah saved you. Allah saved you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We learn also from this part of the story that you fear Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah gives you more than you expect. How many times you thought that you lost it? And then you find someone coming to you, wanting you to do something for them, and it keeps opening the gates of Allah's mercy for you, subhanAllah. Many times. And that's why it comes there. And they see the characteristics of Musa alayhi salam being strong, because they saw that demonstration of strength. Some of the narration says that he carried the lid from the well, because those men, they put the lid back, they did not care about the sisters. So he carried some lid that 10 people carry. He gave them what they want and then he put it back while he's being exhausted and tired. So that's why she said, oh father, hire him because he's strong. And why she said he's honest? Because Musa alayhi salam did not look to them in a bad way, did not look to them with lust or in a physical way. And some of the narrations said that he went in front of her and told her, give me direction while you are behind. He does not want to look at her back while she's leading him. Ameen. That's why also it shows that she's giving a hint that she wants to get married, that she likes him. She wanted him to be hired because of that. And the father knew what his daughter is saying, so he said, I'm going to marry you to one of them. See the communication here between father, daughter, the environment of faith. My brothers and my sisters, there are lessons to learn from this part of the story of Musa alayhi salam. How honest he was, how strong he was, how brave he was, how courageous he was, how helpful, how caring he is, how is he taking initiative to help others who need help without them asking. You don't wait until people ask you. So this is what we learned from this segment of the story. Stay with us, because after the break we will continue with this story of Musa alayhi salam and this pious and righteous family. May Allah Azza wa Jalla benefit us all. I'll see you right after the break.
الصلاة على النبي والسلام على الرسول والأنبياء المرسلين كلهم مكرمون.
We welcome you, moms, we all adore. We pray for happiness and more. To all the people, open up your door. Peace, love and joy. Let them soar, let them soar.
We need guidance in our lives. Where can we find this guidance from? We need the Quran to be part of our daily lives. How can we truly live our lives with the Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, revealed this book as a source of guidance, spirit, and direction to all mankind.
إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم.
Indeed, this book guides towards that which is the straightest. And Allah Ta'ala told us the reason behind revealing it.
كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته.
This book, this scripture is full of blessing, and the reason behind revealing it is for people to ponder on it, and men of understanding may reflect.
وليذكر أولو الألباب.
Join us on our brand new program titled Live Your Life, and I will be your host. It's going to be a beautiful journey through the blessed book of Allah. We're going to start from Al-Fatiha and work our way down and look at the very last verse that was revealed to the blessed Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Let's not forget the great teachings of the blessed Prophet, where he said that the best of mankind are those who learn the Quran and those who teach it. So join us on Live Your Life.
الصلاة على النبي والسلام على الرسول والأنبياء المرسلين كلهم مكرمون.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My brothers and sisters, welcome back to the beautiful story of Musa alayhi salam, and with the pious righteous family. The pious righteous family, after Allah saved him from the transgression and Allah saved him from the planning to kill him in Egypt, he went to Madian, and in Madian he found those two girls. They are staying on the side. He asked them, what is wrong? Why you are not getting the water that you want? She said that we want to get the water, but we wait until all these shepherds, they finish, so we can have our turn. And our father is a very old man. And that, my brothers and sisters, it shows here that they say, we wouldn't be here if it is not for our circumstances. One, our father is an old person, so he cannot come. So they are stating here that we would not be here if our father could do it. That shows the place that they believe that they should belong to. Also, it shows haya of the women, modesty and shyness. They do not just go there for the sake of it. And this is a lesson for us. Sometimes there are activities and programs, and before you do the activity, you find some voices in the community saying, where are the sisters? Do you have a sister presenter? Where are the lectures that the sisters give? First, see what are we talking about? See who is the best qualified person for it, a brother or a sister, it doesn't matter. What if there is no qualified sisters to talk about this subject? We just put a sister for the sake of it? That's actually unfair for the sisters themselves. That's unfair for the sisters themselves, subhanAllah. So, it is not fair to act like this. You see how the sisters themselves here saying in the Quran, our father is an old man, so we wouldn't have been coming if he was able to. And they wait until the shepherd is there. So that's what made Musa alayhi salam help them and support them. Haya and modesty. Knowing your place, knowing your level, has nothing wrong about it, is not shameful, and is nothing wrong. It is actually the way we all should behave. Also, we learn how Musa alayhi salam was honest and trustworthy with them, was honest and trustworthy with their father. When he made a commitment, I'm going to take care and I'll be your shepherd instead of your daughters. Musa alayhi salam did not go and say, no, thank you so much, just give me some money and I don't need to get married. No. He wanted shelter, he wanted food, and he was offered, so he accepted it. And the other man, the father here, he wanted his daughter to get married, and he wanted to hire someone, and he wants to pay him as well. So everybody's benefiting. And the sisters wanted to get married, and they found someone honest and trustworthy. They expressed their need indirectly, and there's nothing wrong in a sister expressing her need to get married, directly or indirectly. And this is a lesson for us also. You see how easy marriage is. How easy marriage is. And nobody should say here that the father did not take the permission of the daughter. Actually, he did, because they were hearing the conversation. Learn, read the Quran. قالت إحداهما, one of them said, my father, teach, hire him. So she was listening back and forth. And when the father says something, the daughter did not disagree. That means she agrees. When they were walking to Musa, Allah Azza wa Jalla described, when she was walking to Musa to invite him, فجاءت إحداهما تمشي على استحياء. She's coming and walking modestly. She's not like walking like with haughtiness and all of that. She said, hey, yo, come on, my dad want to give you a reward for what you did. No, استحياء, modestly, talking to him nicely. Yeah. So the result of that is the karam of Allah, the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Musa alayhi salam. He gets married, he gets a job, he gets, his payment is that he got married, he got a family. So Musa alayhi salam finished his term. فَلَمَّا قَضَى مُوسَى الْأَجَلِ Al-ajal here means the best of the two. Means 10 years. Musa alayhi salam finished 10 years. It's of service working. And that shows us here, the mahr, if somebody does not have money, can be an action. It's preferable, as the scholar said. I see many sisters and many brothers, they give the mahr as a commodity, or as, you know, give mahr the Quran, or give mahr teaching of surah, or doing such and such. No. Actually, that if you don't have money. If you have money, you should give even a dollar, even an iron ring, as Rasulullah said. So here the mahr was paid in work. 10 years of work for a mahr for a woman, subhanAllah. That is an expensive one. 10 years of your life to work for the parents or the father of your wife. Amazing. Then Musa alayhi salam finished that, and he takes his family and travel. Allah Azza wa Jal chose him to become a prophet of Allah. So he found in the mountain of At-Tur, he's going toward Egypt. He found the mountain of At-Tur, he's found like a light or shine there. Now they are walking in the desert, in the dark, the cold. So he tells his family, his wife, he tells them to stay where they are. Umkuthu, wait here. I'm going to see that fire, and I'm going to go get you some of that fire, or light from that fire, so we can light our night here, and we can find some warmth. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَصْطَلُونَ You can find the warmth, and you can use it, and we can also light our night, our way through the night. Traveling at night was a very common thing. Then he receives the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah talks to him and he said, Ya Musa, I am your Lord. How did Allah talk to him? Allah knows best. But Musa alayhi salam is among those who chosen to talk to Allah without any barrier, without any medium. There is a hijab, but there is no medium. Jibreel is not there. Allah talks directly to Musa alayhi salam in a way that befits him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he tells him, I am your Lord, and you are standing in a pure land. Take off your shoes. So Musa alayhi salam, talking to Allah, is in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tells him, I am choosing you, Ya Musa. I chose you to become my prophet. And you have to go to Fir'aun. Subhanallah. The one he ran away from, Allah is ordering him to go back to. Same thing. The one they scared from, he has to go through the river Nile for him. This pattern goes through the whole surah, subhanAllah, to show us the hikmah and the power of Allah. Trust Allah, my brothers and sisters. Trust Allah and do what you are ordered, and always expect the best from Rabbul Alameen, subhanahu wa ta'ala, even after a while. So Allah Azza wa Jal tell him, you are going to go to Fir'aun. So Musa alayhi salam said, Ya Allah, I killed someone from them, and I'm afraid that they will kill me. And my brother Harun knows better, so Ya Allah, send him with me. So Allah said, yeah, we will send Harun with you as a support. And when you are afraid, just put your hand under your armpit, and you will feel safe. And your cane, throw it, and you will see a snake coming, as an ayah from Allah Azza wa Jal. And when he removes his hand out, it will shine. Allah Azza wa Jalla give him this ayat. Two ayahs. The snake and Allah makes his hand shine. And if you are scared, just put your hand in your chest. And you will feel safe. So now you go to, you have to save Bani Israel. Save Bani Israel from Al-Azab Al-Muhim. From this punishment and torment, humiliating torment of Pharaoh to Bani Israel in Egypt. Musa was ordered to save them. One man will save them from the most transgressive king who says, Ana Rabbukum Al-A'la, I am your highest lord of lords. Musa alayhi salam will save Bani Israel. And he will. Again, when you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make things happen on your hand that you never imagined. Never ever imagine with the least of effort. Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you victory. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will show you the way. Allah will keep you on the path. So also shows us that Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَلَمَّا قَضَى مُوسَى الْأَجَلَ وَسَارَ بِأَهْلِهِ. His ahl, he's the leader. And it shows how Musa cares about his family and how he does not want to expose them to danger. He wants to keep them safe. Stay here in safety, and I, the man, will go and get you what you need. And then how Musa alayhi salam standing firm with that supernatural powerful experience. And how when Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking to Musa alayhi salam, he's telling him, what is that in your hand? Allah knows what is in his hand. He tell him, this is my cane. I depend on it while I'm walking. And I protect my sheep from the wolves with it. And I have other things to do. And these other things, Allah knows. Mufassirin said, oh, he used to put it in the ground and it becomes miraculously a tree and he does many things with it. But that's not our concern now. He was trying to make the conversation longer with Allah Azza wa Jal. He could have said, this is a cane. What is that in your hand, Ya Musa? Cane. Asa. But he said, Hiya, it is Asaya, my cane. Atawakka'u alayha. I'm leaning on it when I'm walking, using it as a support. Wahushu biha ala ghanami. And my sheep, you know, I protect my sheep. Waliya fiha. See, all this, like he is using these words to extend the conversation with Rabbil Alameen. So there's a lesson for us. When you are about to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you want to extend it. You don't want to just cut it short and pray fast because it's a duty you just want to get over with. No. With the salihin and the pious and righteous, they want to extend the time that they spend with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With Allah, we enjoy the relationship. With our women, we protect them, we honor them, we respect them, we give them their rights. We don't wait for them to ask for it or fight for it. With the community, we are fair and we want to help the transgressed and we want to stand in front of the transgressor by all means. If we can do it with our hands or with our tongues, or at least you don't agree with them with your heart. And with the believers, we deal with them with respect and humility and humbleness. And with the non-believers, we deal with them also with respect if they are not attacking or not supporting anybody against us. So story of Musa alayhi salam is full of admonitions and advice. Beautiful story. We love Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Prophet Musa is dearer to us than anyone who claims him. We claim him more than anyone else because he is the brother of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He is our beloved Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and he's the one we follow more than anyone else. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us more lessons from this beautiful story of Musa. And until I see you in another episode, بإذن الله تعالى, talking about this beautiful story of this Prophet of Allah, Musa alayhi salam, I leave you in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go read Surah Al-Qasas, learn from the story of Musa alayhi salam. And until I see you, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Adam, Idris, Nuh, Hud, Saleh, إبراهيم لوط إسماعيل إسحاق يعقوب يوسف أيوب شعيب موسى هارون ذو الكفل داود سليمان إلياس اليسعى يونس زكريا يحيى عيسى آدم إدريس نوح صالح إبراهيم لوط إسماعيل إسحاق يعقوب يوسف أيوب شعيب موسى هارون ذو الكفل داود سليمان إلياس اليسعى يونس زكريا يحيى عيسى والآخر الخاتم الأنبياء محمد المصطفى.